Well, 40 points higher on the Nifty and 145 higher on the Bank Nifty. It's just relentless one-way move. Sudarshan, what's the 9-10 call? Is there a trade on the index? If not, on individual stock?
Yeah, well, there is no trade in the index at this gap up. This needs to cool down to 10,340 or so for the Nifty, and the Bank Nifty also must come below yesterday's close. Otherwise, markets can go up, but I would not be there to add money. Buying would be done only on dips. Pidilite is a buying opportunity with 1166 as a stop and 1192 as a target. As I explained, it has an excellent chart.
Okay. Mitesh, you have the courage to buy a Nifty Bank at these levels, or would you also wait for dips?
No, I think, in fact, I'm looking to take profits at least partially on the Bank Nifty today with this gap up opening of 0.5%, 150 points higher or so, and we'll wait for dips. And the, on stock specific side, I have a buy on ABB with a stop at 1270 for targets of 1350.
Okay, Prakash, what's your 9-10 call? And okay, I'll ask you the next set of stocks in a bit.
I like MGL, Mahanagar Gas Limited. I think it's heading to 1948 zone, stop below 915.
Okay. All right. Well, Ajay, let us end where we began. We began by asking you about banks, especially IndusInd. What's your pick of the pack? Would you now look at any of the PSU banks, or are you going to once again stick with private banks? If yes, which?
Yeah, I think on the corporate focus banks, preference would be ICICI Bank with a medium-term target of around 450 rupees over the next 12 to 15 months. And in case of retail focus banks, I think I would be a bit contrarian. Kotak Bank has underperformed the peers because of understandably because of the overhang of the promoter stake sale. But as I've said that, I think, you know, in case the regulator were to rule, the court were to rule in favor of regulator, there is no dearth of willing buyers queuing up to buy Mr. Uday Kotak stake, because the bank is the jewel in the Indian banking, in the crown of Indian banking space. So I think I would venture out and look at a slightly medium-term commitment for Kotak Mahindra Bank.
All right. Thanks a lot, Ajay, for joining us today. By the way, that block deal on Jubilant has actually happened at a much higher price than perhaps was assumed, 1312.4, if that pre-open rate is right. Prakash, before we thank you, any chart check on Jubilant?
Jubilant. Well, yeah. Let me see it, Jubilant. I think Jubilant is looking sideways. I would avoid it.
Okay. Prakash, thanks a lot for joining us. Sudarshan, your thoughts on a stock like Bharti Airtel? Would you buy it here?
No, I would not buy it. You know, some of these moves are random. Bharti Airtel is in a deep downtrend. There will be bear market rallies. I'd classify this as a bear market rally in Bharti Airtel. I would not touch it.
Okay, what about Z Entertainment? That stock once again is bouncing back. I mean, not just today because there are news reports, but otherwise it's risen about 40% from the lows. Sudarshan?
Well, it has bounced back, but this V-shaped rally is again a suspect to me. I think it will consolidate at current levels. Maybe a few months later, or sometime later, it's a buy. Again, it's not a buy for me.
Okay. Well, I really want to concentrate on the FII favorites because that's where the action seems to be. So I want your views on, stocks like HDFC Bank and IndusInd and Reliance. Mitesh, if you can start, would you be buying any of these three stocks now?
So we had a buy on Reliance yesterday and the day before as well, and HDFC Bank also yesterday. Again, they've run up too fast, Lata. So not the best entry point from a risk-reward equation because the stop-losses are still deeper. So not buying as of now, but I would be comfortable holding HDFC Bank for targets of around 23.20 to about 23.50 on the upside. And Reliance, I would trail my stop-loss about 13.19 and hold the long position.
Okay. Sudarshan, similar question to you. IndusInd, HDFC Bank and Reliance, they have been spearheading the rally.
No, HDFC Bank and Reliance must be part of every portfolio. So even at current levels, you buy them and 1 year later, 2 years later, you will be rewarded. So there is, but HDFC Bank's current run-up tells us that it must cool down before we re-enter. And the same applies to Reliance. So for a very short-term trade, you have to be patient. And IndusInd Bank is just coming out of a base. It's a very attractive buy even for the short-term trader.
Okay. Well, so it's buy, and then with the foreign fund flowing the way it is, it looks like the going is going to be good. I don't think we can squeeze in another question. We just have 10 seconds. But actually, the top of the rally today, I mean, heading the Nifty list of greens is actually Yes Bank. up 1.4, and closely followed by Z. But let's see how things pan out. The first tick is 0.25% higher, so 11,396. We were almost at 400, 11,396, but now at 11,370. So 0.25% up on the Nifty. Sensex up 100. That's again 0.25%, so that's 37,856. We're almost at 38,000. And the Nifty Bank, again, today it's at, for the moment, it's just as good as the Sensex and Nifty, up 0.25%, 69 points higher, 28,959, so not yet scaled 29,000. For today, actually, the mid-cap's also doing well. Okay.
The Nifty Bank hit that 29,000.
No, I tell you something before you talk about individuals, maybe, you know, the Nifty
DHFL
stocks. No, the stock of the moment is Lupin, because, you know, there were a lot of shorts which were created yesterday. My sense is that, you know, those shorts have been trapped now because the news perhaps is not as negative as you thought initially it would be. And, like, you know, a lot of brokerages are also saying that it perhaps is not going to impact the stock. I think that's the one where yesterday's lows not being broken. And if that is the case, my sense is you would see a lot of short covering, because everyone who shorted yesterday would be forced to cover. This is that kind of market where people are looking to buy, you know, any perceived bad news.
Buy the distress.
Exactly.
Actually,
so
that's what I was asking Ajay and Ame as well.
Yes.
And Ame was saying that, yes, he would buy the distress.
Yes.
But yeah, that's a stock worth watching. We thought it would be negative news. And after just an initial dip, look at the way the stock has, you know, sprung up like a rubber band. Z Entertainment as well, expectations of the deal with Sony coming through. Nisha told us that first, but it's now just getting corroborated by other reports as well. Up 1.8%. India Bulls Housing is jumping 1.6. Yes Bank 1.5. HCL Tech 1%. Minor acquisition there. NTPC 1%. NTPC, Coal India, HDFC, Axis are all up almost 1%. 0.7, 0.8 thereabouts. Important point to note, today the IT stocks are not lagging. I mean, you're seeing Infosys also among the gainers with about a 0.7 in the bag already. What's seeing profit taking? Power Grid is seeing profit taking, 3% down. Oil marketing stocks are seeing falls. I mean, crude is almost at 68. So there's a bit of a knock over there. If you want to take money somewhere, it seems to be the oil marketing companies today. HPBP down 1.5. Other stocks mildly in the red are Adani Ports, Tata Motors, Gail, Grasim, Titan, Bajaj Auto, Bharti Airtel. Down about 0.25% to 0.5% in those stocks. But net-net, the market has held on to the gains, and it's up 0.33% now.
Oh yes, it's a good opening for the mid-cap index as well, Lata, up about 0.3%. The market breadth is positive, 3-1 in favour of the advances. DHFL is the stock that's really moving up higher after reports indicated that the NHB did tests and there was no deviations in any of DHFL's books. So perhaps vindicated of sorts there, up about 5-odd%. You know, some of the NBFCs are looking pretty good. JM Financial, Motilal Oswal, from the larger guys, India Bulls Housing, IIFL Holdings, all trading in the green by about 3-5-odd%. So keep an eye out on that. Lemon Tree, after making that acquisition of Keys, is up in the green, almost about 2-odd% over there. And Jubilant Foods is also in the green right now, up almost about 2-odd% post that deal that took place. Apart from that, on the losing end, you do have a couple of these infrastructure names, the ADAG stocks. So Relcom is down, JP Power is down, Power Grid under a bit of pressure there, NCC, CG Power. But stripped of that, it's actually a good opening, decent opening for the market, you'd have to say. The Nifty continues to inch forward. The Bank Nifty has hit a fresh record high. That Anuj, continues to be the star, right? The Bank Nifty, now 29,000 plus.
Yeah, but, you know, you just want to take some off right now. We're at 29,000. And then see, then wait for a bit of a dip before you buy. Because, once again, there's just too much happening too soon. Jubilant, by the way, is interesting because it's actually seeing massive buying immediately after that. You know, perhaps the fact that that block happened at much higher volume, much higher you know, price than, you know.
As Ajay interprets, probably the interpretation is that, okay, they've sold to take away some of the pledge. Mm-hmm. Now you're in the money, maybe you can reduce the pledge. Perhaps that's why it's the overhang is seen as less.
Okay,
but
I just want to point out one thing. You know, Tata Motors is a stock that's under pressure once again today. Apparently, Jaguar Land Rover has been forced to recall over 44,000 cars as the UK regulators have found some models were emitting more carbon dioxide than previously thought. That's what The Guardian reported last evening. So, you know, in any case, there's a lot of bad news, but this is additional bad news.
Yeah, I think this is official news. I think we should flash it because it recalled 44,000 cars.
It's a big that's number.
Yes, and that's 10 models maybe emitting more CO2 than certified. these were models built between 2016 to 2019, and that's a big recall. And Tata Motors anyway has got some more negativity because of what's happening with Brexit, and so the environment is a bit uncertain, but yeah, a bit of a decline on that stock right now.
Yes, a kiss of death, isn't it? Whatever Mr. Ratan Tata has bought has not really been very helpful, Chorus or JLR. Okay, for the markets itself, there's really no stopping the Nifty Bank. I mean, it's just going from strength to strength, and I would assume, again, the HDFC twins are helping a lot. HDFC, IndusInd Bank is up 1%. HDFC Bank is up almost 1%. Axis Bank is up 1%. So, I mean, no matter where you look, there's support coming for the Nifty Bank. Another, okay, 0.6. Before you finish the sentence, it's gained a little more. So, very good going across the board for all the markets. Sudarshan, changed your view on Nifty Bank, or you will still wait for that dip?
No, I'll wait for a dip. Lata, dips come. We know that, and this momentum is not worth buying. So wait patiently. Markets will correct, and this lifetime new highs can be bought at a lower level.
Okay. Well, Mitesh, any thoughts on the market opening? A couple of these oil marketing companies are a bit under pressure right now, but anything that catches your eye?
So, you know, I was talking about taking some profits on the Bank Nifty, but the two stocks which I like immediately are both banking stocks, HDFC and IDFC First Bank. HDFC showing good continuation, I think could head towards targets close to about 2000 to begin with, and then higher levels maybe. And IDFC First, after a few days of consolidation, is also showing signs of an upward continuation. So I would be a buyer there as well. Look at targets close to about 54.
Okay, Tata Motors is now making news of the day, just of the morning. So that news is being perceived quite negatively. In fact, that's the biggest Nifty loser now. Almost 2% down is what you have on the stock. Mitesh, it filled that gap, but after that, it sort of topped out a bit. Do you see more downside from here?
Anuj, there's certainly a good chance of that happening. The intraday charts have broken down. The only thing is that it's at an important moving average at 177, but I think that'll break. And having you know, assuming that, that happens, I think the stock could go some 170 again. 166 is what I'm looking at, actually.
Okay. Well, it's two stocks in the green for one in the red. So, quite clearly today, breadth and breakout are all happening simultaneously. Gentlemen, thank you very much for joining us through the pre-market and staying for the opening market trades.